Hello again, this is Dr. Lindsay. And in this video, what I want to go over is this idea of full employment. What does full employment mean in the economy? We're never going to have an unemployment rate that's at zero. Never. Because there's always going to be some people that are unemployed for frictional unemployment and structural unemployment. So how much is that? You know, what should it be if the economy is doing great? Well, we can think of this natural rate of employment or unemployment to be full employment. So in other words, we should have some unemployment that is equal to frictional plus structural. So frictional plus structural is normal. So that means that if we added those up together, that frictional and structural unemployment together, that would be some sort of normal or healthy amount to have an economy. In fact, it would be equal to full employment. So say, for example, frictional unemployment is 2% of the labor force, and structural unemployment is 4% of the labor force. Well, that means that 6%, an unemployment rate of 6%, would be normal. And that would be full employment. So if that economy had a 6% unemployment, then we would say that's full employment. So full employment means that there is only frictional and structural unemployment. So graphically, if we were to draw this on the PPF, remember that full employment is out here on the PPF, and that's not zero. That being out there on the PPF still means that there is some frictional unemployment and structural unemployment. It just means that cyclical unemployment is zero. So full employment, remember, is right here, and that is at the point where cyclical unemployment equals zero. If we are inside the PPF, this means that there's some idle resources in the economy. It means we're not producing at potential. It means there's unemployed resources. Either there's machines that aren't being used, they're idle, or there's people that are idle. And inside the PPF here means that there's some amount of cyclical unemployment. So there is some cyclical unemployment. So the question is, well, what is full employment? What is normal unemployment? When we're out there on the PPF, what should it be? It's not clear. But you can look at the data just as well as anyone else and decide for yourself what it should be. The thinking by economists is that if unemployment is somewhere around 4 to 6%, that's full employment. So an unemployment rate of say 4 to 6% means right here on the PPF. Higher than that means that we have cyclical unemployment and we're inside the PPF. So a point down here might be something like 15%. The higher it is, the further we're going to be inside the PPF. Something really low, like 3.5%, means we're actually outside the PPF. We've gone beyond the potential output. It's not sustainable to stay out there, but temporarily, we can go beyond the PPF for a short period of time. Now I'm going to show you a graph of unemployment going back to about 1900. This only goes up to about 2000. And this black line here is at 5%. About the middle range of what people think is full employment. So you can look at this graph too and try to figure out what is full employment. Because it's not like we go back to a certain point every time and bounce off it and very clear to see from the graph what is full employment and what isn't. It's hard to tell. Because sometimes we're way down below and sometimes we're way above. You can see down to 1944, it got pretty low, 43 or so, probably because of World War II. And maybe also there in 1918, it looks like, came down low because of unemployment. You can see how it got real high during the Depression. So as far as figuring out what is full employment, as I say, you can look at the graphs and look at it and decide for yourself what you think it is, just as well as anybody else. But the economists don't really know. They just say somewhere between 4 and 6%. Now, next category here, the topic here I want to go over is the Federal Reserve and their unemployment and unemployment. So our Federal Reserve, which we'll get into later, cares a lot about the unemployment rate. So if our PPF looks like something like this here, where we PPF is our potential, it's determined by the production function. If we're inside the PPF, it means we've got this cyclical unemployment, downturn in the economy, something greater than 4 to 6%. And the Federal Reserve watches this carefully. And they're expected to do something about it. One of the mandates of the Federal Reserve is to try to keep the economy at full employment. Now, how can they do that? Well, economists know that expanding the money supply stimulates the economy. And so expanding the money supply will actually tend to push us out in the direction of the PPF if we're inside it, and maybe even beyond it with enough money. And the Federal Reserve controls the money supply. So the Federal Reserve has quite a bit of power because they've got a lot of power over the economy because they control the money supply. And they can expand the economy or contract the economy by either expanding the money supply or contracting the money supply. And so Congress has given the Federal Reserve a mandate, and that is to try to keep the economy such that we are out on the edge of the PPF, which means full employment or maximum sustainable employment is what they call it. Keep the economy at maximum sustainable employment. Not maximum employment, because anything outside the PPF is not sustainable. So maximum sustainable employment means try to keep the economy right here on the edge of the PPF and use the money supply to do that.